This is Duke University.
Hello, my name is Bridget Fletcher. I'm the Associate Director for Academic and Student Services for Pratt Professional Master's Programs. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Duke University. I'm joined today by current Master of Engineering Management student, Allende Cornejo, to talk to you a little bit about student life and to give you some tips, tricks, and outlines for things that you'll want to be aware of as you prepare for your trip to Duke. Today we'll be talking about housing, transportation, parking, and also getting a part-time job at Duke. Choosing where you're going to live when you come to Duke is going to be extremely important for you, and it's something we want you to start thinking about right now. Unfortunately, it's very difficult for graduate students to find housing on campus. It's not something that's guaranteed, so you should probably proceed with the assumption that you'll be living off campus. That's going to be our focus for today. Many apartment complexes near to campus will fill up as early as June or July, so this is something you'll want to focus on this month pretty much immediately. In terms of finding a roommate, it's going to be very important that you do that quickly so you can make the decision about where you'll live together. If you're interested in living with someone inside your program, check the MEM or MEng admitted Facebook pages for potential roommates. If you're interested in living with someone outside of your program, you can check the Duke list or Craigslist, which we'll talk about a bit later. As you can see here, the Pratt School of Engineering is located centrally to many of the apartment complexes that are available to you. We've got several to the north and south of campus, all within walking distance. These are what we're going to focus on today.
Now, we are going to show you one by one the different housing possibilities, explaining the apartment details and amenities along the way. At the end, there is a summary of the apartments, floor plans, prices, and the distance of each apartment complex to campus. Please take a look also to the document attached to this email because it gives you a full information. Belmont has one or two bedroom apartments with a washer drying in each unit. It is a gated community. It takes only 18 minutes to walk to campus, but there is also a bus stop outside of the gate. Belmont offers a fitness center, jogging track around a lake, and swimming pool. Barnes Place offers only three bedroom apartments, with a washer and dryer in each unit. There is a bus stop outside of the community, and it takes about 25 minutes to walk to campus. Fitness center, jogging track, and swimming pool are included. Campus Walk offers two and three bedroom floor plans with a washer and dryer in each unit. It takes about 17 minutes to walk to campus, and the bus stop is outside. The Heights offers one and two bedroom apartment with a washer and dryer in every unit. Free breakfast until 9 a.m. is included. It is a gated community, and it takes 20 minutes to walk to campus. The bus stop is located outside of the gate. Offers fitness center and swimming pool. The Lofts. The apartments have one and two bedroom with washer and dryer in each unit. It is a gated community. It is located closer to campus and only takes 10 minutes to walk. Fitness center, movie theater, conference room, and covered parking is included.
The university apartments are another great choice for you. They're located on the other side of campus, and they have great proximity via bike or bus to get to West Campus, where most of your classes will be held. They have one and two bedroom plans, washers and dryers in most units, granite countertops, an alarm system, the Duke van service, which we'll talk about later, services this apartment complex. It's pet friendly, has a fitness center and a saltwater swimming pool. University Commons is owned by the same people that run the university apartments. They're very well managed and newly updated. They have one and two bedroom plans, a washer and dryer in most units, large closets, van service also goes here, pet friendly, fitness center, and a swimming pool. They also offer furniture packages, so if you need something that's furnished, you can potentially work something out with them. It's a great choice for you. In summary, this gives you a look at the price range. Those that have each next to them indicate what the cost would be per roommate. Those that list the larger full price give you an idea of what it would cost to be in the whole unit. Gives you an idea about whether something is gated or not, if there's a pool and gym, and it tells you the distance via walking to West Campus where your classes will be. You'll also find that attached to the email where you received this video, there's a summary sheet that gives you all of this information plus more.
We want to show you other housing where current or former students of the program have lived and recommend. Bell West End or 605 West offers 1- and 2-bedroom plans with washer and dryer in unit. A great advantage of this apartment is that they are furnished and cable is included. They are close to downtown and also to campus. The bus stop of the number 6 or 6B is outside and takes 10 minutes to get to West Campus. It is equipped with study rooms, fitness center, and swimming pool. Claremont, this apartment complex offers 1, 2, and 3-bedroom plans with washer and dryer in unit. It is a gated community, pet-friendly, with 24-hour fitness center with yoga area and swimming pool. Berkshire at 90th Street offers 1, 2, and 3-bedroom apartments with washer and dryer in unit. It is located in downtown, with supermarkets close by. It also includes a fitness center with flex studio and rock climbing, and a saltwater swimming pool. Here you can find a summary of the three alternatives in terms of the number of rooms in each apartment, pricing, or the distance to campus. Other recommendations are Trinity Commons, Holly Hill, Erwin Terrace, and Blue Crest. Please check the spreadsheet attached to this email with this video for additional information. If you have any questions about housing, let us know. You can contact me. My name is Allende and my email is mc490@duke.edu.
Next, we'd like to talk to you about transportation and parking here at Duke. Transportation is something that's going to be really important to you, particularly because you're very likely to be living off campus. Duke has a great bus system. There are also city buses that will be available to you. Duke also offers safe vans during those times when the bus is not operating. Duke also offers a car share system where you can rent a car hourly and does not require a U.S. driver's license. An international license is okay. Duke and Durham are also very bike and scooter friendly. There are a lot of bike lanes here that you can use. And bikes and scooters are very easily attainable through a variety of sources. Once you arrive, we can talk to you about that. There are also taxis here, and Uber and Lyft are very active. We also wanted to let you know that the Duke van service that we talked about has a pretty extensive area that it covers. This gives you an idea of where it will go. Most of the apartment complexes that we've talked about fall within the Duke van service range.
GoPass is a card for free transportation that you will get here in orientation week. It works also for catching the bus to and from Raleigh and Chapel Hill. To know how to move between campus and your apartments or around the triangle, you can use the Translog application or Google Maps. Please see the attached document to know more about transportation.
Parking is definitely something that you'll want to consider if you choose to purchase or bring a car with you to campus. Cars are nice to have in Durham, but certainly aren't necessary. As we mentioned, there's a lot of transportation options, so please don't feel like you have to have a car to be able to get around here. Should you choose to bring one, please note that Duke's campus is not particularly car friendly. This is not a campus that was designed for a lot of on-campus vehicles, so a lot of what you'll find is remote parking with buses or walks into campus. You'll find in the document that's attached to the email you received information about obtaining a parking pass, what garage parking options you'll have, and what your options are for parking for free on campus.
Part-time jobs at Duke. Even if the maximum time we are allowed to work on campus is 19.9 hours a week, we recommend 10 hours a week because of the workload of the program. Places where you can look are Duke List, networking with professors to help as teacher or research assistant, or even work for MEM or MNs like I'm doing this summer. For more information, please see the document attached.
Thank you so much for spending time with Allende and I today. We hope this video has helped you make some decisions as you prepare for your epic journey to Duke. Thank you.